Let's take a look at a couple more derivatives that involve the exponential function with base e. Here we have f of x equals the quantity e to the power of 3x minus 1 raised to the fifth power. So we'll be using both the extended power rule and the derivative for e to the u. First thing we should notice is that we have a composite function. Therefore, we'll let the inner function equal u. So u will be e to the 3x minus 1. So now we can write this as u to the fifth. But we know as soon as we identify u, we're going to need u prime. So now we need to differentiate e to the power of 3x minus 1. But this in itself is a composite function. Looking at our formula here, for e to the 3x, we'd have to let u equal 3x. But since we've already used u, we'll go ahead and call this v. So the derivative of e to the v would be e to the v times v prime. So u prime is going to be equal to e to the 3x times the derivative of 3x, which would be 3, and then minus the derivative of 1, which is 0. So this would be 3 e to the 3x. So now to determine f prime of x, we can differentiate u to the fifth with respect to x, which would be 5 u to the fourth times u prime, but u is e to the power of 3x minus 1, and u prime is 3 e to the power of 3x. Now let's go ahead and clean this up a little bit. F prime of x is going to be equal to, this will be 15 e to the 3x times the quantity e to the 3x minus 1 to the fourth power. This one was so much fun, let's try another. Here we have f of x equals the square root of 2 times e to the power of x cubed plus 1. So the first thing we need to do is rewrite this as a rational exponent. So we have the quantity 2 e to the x to the third power plus 1 to the power of 1 half. The next thing we need to recognize, this is the composite function where u is going to be the inner function. So u is going to be equal to 2 e to the power of x cubed plus 1. And then as soon as we identify u, we know we need u prime. To determine u prime, we have to apply the chain rule when we differentiate e to the power of x cubed. Looking at our formula here, we normally let the exponent equal u, but since we've already used u here, let's go ahead and let x cubed equal v. So the derivative of 2 times e to the v would be 2 times e to the v times v prime. Well, if v is x cubed, v prime would be 3x squared, plus a derivative of 1, which would be 0. So this would be 6x squared e to the x cubed. Now we can determine f prime because we can think of this as u to the 1 half. So the derivative of u to the 1 half with respect to x would be 1 half u to the negative 1 half, where u is 2 e to the x cubed plus 1 times u prime, and u prime is 6x squared e to the x cubed. And one last step here to clean this up. 1 half times 6, that would be 3 x squared e to the x cubed. And this is a negative exponent, so we'll move it down to the denominator. We can write this as the quantity 2 e to the x cubed plus 1 to the positive 1 half, or if we want, we could write this as a square root. We'll take a look at some more examples in the next video.